going to be a little bit different, because there ain't going to be no rumors. If you haven't seen it yet, I'm sure you will. And I want you to make sure that you understand that what's going to happen following this, I really don't care about. It really doesn't bother me, because if me and my brothers can't go through this, then we don't deserve to be called the Freebirds. We don't deserve to be called the Boys from Bad Street. Now, Akbar, yeah, you're one up. You and that bull-headed geek who I took into my home. My brother's taught everything he ever learned, and he switched on us for money. Like you weren't making any, you weren't making a dime before you came to us, boy. But that's fine, man. I'm glad you showed your true colors. Because I tell you what, man, when Bam Bam found this out, he cut that tour from Japan off real early. So now we're going to find out why Bill Irwin, One Man Subdivision, and you, Akbar, you, yeah, I don't like being set up. I don't like being treated like a fool. But there's one thing that I do like, and that's getting even. You might look at me now and say I'm mad, but you wait till Bam Bam gets back and we get even, and you're going to have to do it. You're going to have to walk down Bad Street.
Well, there's nothing worse than a turncoat, and I'm sure that Michael Hayes feels exactly that way. Obviously, feelings are going to run deep here, and there will be a conflict between these two forces. What kind of a conflict, what kind of a match it would call for, still remains to be seen. We have another match coming up now from the UWF. It will be the massive one-man gang going up against Savannah Jack.
Now he's in trouble. Let's see what the weight, the solid weight of the huge man can do to the skill of Savannah Jack. Jack in trouble as the pounding comes down and starts after him. As you can see the confidence with which the one-man gang stands behind him. That's a good place to be if you want to build up confidence. But Savannah Jack sometimes is able to use those feet of his in a reverse fashion, so we'll be watching that.
Hard blow by One Man Gang. Regardless how Savannah Jack makes out tonight in his title match, he will be defending his UWF TV championship against Iceman King Parsons. One of two title matches, in addition to the six-person elimination tag, when Dark Journey, Missing Link, and Chavo Guerrero go up against Sunshine and the Freebirds, Michael Hayes and Buddy Jack Roberts. More matches are being signed outside the ring. It looks like we've got a battle continuing on with Ted DiBiase and General Akbar. Inside the ring, we have the UWF title showdown, and that is what the fans are watching along with that battle outside the ring. It's impossible to bring you all the action. That's why we encourage you to come down in person, catch all the color and excitement and thrills of Houston Wrestling live and in person right here in the Coliseum. Oh, he came charging across like an avalanche, and Savannah Jack was able to get out of the way just in time.
He got away in time, and that ring shook. You could see as he hit that turnbuckle, the ring literally stretched. And now as he starts to set him up, there's a quick switch. It is trouble for Savannah Jack, but not too much. Come up with a foot.
Oh, what a kick. What a kick. He's on top. Two and oh.
Into the ring comes Sando Akbar. And Akbar, I believe, has deliberately gotten his man disqualified to protect the title.
Well, Savannah Jack had landed the kick. He was on top, and it looked like he was going to get that third count.
DiBiase's in the ring.
DiBiase's in the ring, and we've got all four men battling. The bell is sounding. Savannah Jack is going to win on this qualification, it looks like, but he doesn't win the title. But Ted DiBiase knocking one-man gang down and out of the ring. Savannah Jack, the winner on a disqualification. But he came so close. And if General Akbar had quickly come to the aid of one-man gang, we would have had a new Universal Wrestling Federation heavyweight champion. Savannah Jack proving one more time he is a champion, and it could be just a matter of time before he beats one-man gang for that UWF heavyweight title.
Feels he's got him here. The horns of the bull. pro wrestling this weekend. Gordon, it's time now for our Matt Classic.
And I'll tell you what, over the years, I think some of the greatest women wrestlers in the world have been former world's champion Mildred Burke, June Byers, the fabulous Moolah, Misty Blue Sims, Ella Waldeck. I could go on and on and on. But certainly one of the outstanding women's champions was June Byers. We're going to go back over 30 years now and watch June Byers in the highlights of her match against one of her toughest opponents, Betty Hawkins. The title is on the line.
Looking like something out of a nightmare and kicking with the precision of a Lou Groza, the young Miss Hawkins is obviously bent on ruining this fashionable New England affair. What would her mother say? Wham! What's all this talk about the fair sex? Such violence hasn't been seen in Boston since the days of Bunker Hill. This mayhem mama just won't stop, and so far tonight has made the champ look like a chump. Oh, darling, I simply adore your Tony. Allow me to get a closer look. June's been complaining of a headache, and we can't guess why. The two Debs have turned this ball into a brawl, and the boys just love it. Betty wants Junie to get another view of that new shoe style, but Big Daddy rushes to the rescue. However, June knows that it's the women's prerogative to be unreasonable, and she is just that. A brave man indeed, this ref. The half-nude Big Daddy is betrayed as Fat Daddy, but with the courage of a lion, he continues his task. Ball continues to be bounced all over the canvas. Let's play a little ring around the rosy, dearie. Okay, says June, but let's ring you. Here she comes. Whoops, right in the kisser. I guess I had it coming. May I do that again? Just one more time. Just once more. Whoops. Had to be greedy, didn't she? But June, not Christy, but Byers, gets fisty, not misty, as she lands a fat one. Bang, bang, and the contest is over. Winner and still champion, Miss June Byers. The dignified Miss Hawkins praises Big Daddy on a job well done. He, being a gentleman, returns the compliment. Goodbye, June. Hope to see you again soon.
Certainly an exciting title defense by June Byers. Right now, we're going to go to the AWA. You know, ever since Leon Bullpower White returned for that European tour, he's been feuding with Boris Zhukov. Let's take a look at a recent match now between these two.
The whip. The charge of the bull. And Leon White has got it back.
Don't wait.
The champ said, don't wait.
Got him on a run, take him.
Again. The roar of the bull. The sign of the bull.
I think he feels he's got him here.
The horns of the bull with his hand and also in the point of his haircut. Here is a body slam. How much of this can Boris Zhukov handle?
Uh-oh.
Down
look
in the three-point stance here.
Wow.
Uh-oh. Out. Zhukov ducked under that charge of the bull. Both men.
He's only got 10 out there, Rod.
The count's at four. You see Zhukov inside the ring. That's Bullpower White outside. Tremendous camera work again here from the showboat.
Back.
Mike Shields directing it all from the truck. Both men back to their feet. Again, the count starts anew. Full power outside. He's got to get back in there. And every time this happens, the count starts all over again. But also, full power taking a lot of punishment in the process.
You know, I think that Russian's got something in that boot. Oh, we'll find out. Maybe he'll pull it off.
A loaded boot, possibly. Uh-oh. Now, it's an alley fight outside of the ring. Look at the Sheik. The Sheik from behind. Certainly two on one. That gets him to phase. Full power White, but that may have. White hammers the Sheik. White turns and faces Zhukov. But still, it is. Well, I thought the Sheik was going to enter into it a bit more, but the Sheik has decided to backtrack. And now, White chasing them both around.
Get him, White, get him.
Leon Bullpire White giving chase to Sheik adding on L. Casey. White's going to have to get in there quickly or be disqualified. Did you count him out, Gary?
Yeah, he disqualified him.
Both men disqualified.
Both men.
Double count out.
Right.
Gary DeRusha explaining to Larry Nelson the fact that it has been a double count out. Both men outside of the ring, both Zhukov and Leon Bullpower White. But Vern Gagne, I got a feeling we haven't seen the end of this one.
Wrestling this week. And Joe, of course, the next question is, who's the wrestler of the week?
Well, Gordon, you know, it was a tough week when the board sat down to decide. The Nightmares in Deep South won the tag titles. They, of course, should have consideration. But, you know, sometimes what happens outside the ring can be just as important as what goes on in the ring. And that's what led us to this week's Wrestlers of the Week.
Well, we do have Wrestlers of the Week this week. And it, as Joe said earlier in the program, sometimes it's not what the wrestler does in the ring but out of the ring that makes the difference. And that is the case this week. Our Wrestlers of the Week are indeed Bruiser Brody and Red River Jack for coming forward, being identified on the same interview to clear up that controversy. Let's take another look at the two of them side by side.
Well, I wanted to come out there this week with my good friend and make sure you knew and all the people know that Red River Jack is a real good friend of mine, and it ain't got nothing to do with Bruiser Brody right here under this mask.
All right, Bruiser, thank you very much. Thank you, Red River Jack. Maybe that'll answer the question for Gary Hart.
And our special thanks to Bill Mercer of World Class Championship Wrestling for clearing up that issue about Bruiser Brody and Red River Jack. Next week, our fearless predictions. Till then, I'm Gordon Solie.
I'm Joe Pedicino. We'll see you right back here again in 7 days for more Pro Wrestling This Week.
Hey, Carol, did you hear the news about...
Oh, don't tell me. I've already heard enough news. My brain is on tilt.
Yeah, but that's the point. Weekday mornings from 7 till 9. Instead of news, you can relax with laughter watching Mr. Ed, the Addams Family, McHale's Navy, and Dobie Gillis all on TV 58.
Now that's good news.